enchanting, enduring, and full of life. The Bergmannkiez is a hidden gem nestled amidst the bustling streets of Berlin. This charming neighborhood inside Berlin's Kreuzberg district is unique because it was largely untouched by the ravages of war, creating a picturesque backdrop for an array of public markets, restaurants, cafes, and bars. This neighborhood boldly breaks free from the commonplace clichés often tied to Berlin, creating an authentic and refreshing experience. I love the Bergmannkiez because it's the best of both worlds, a harmonious blend between new and old. This guide is the first in a two-part series about the Bergmannkiez. Today, we're gonna focus on its timeless classics. Having shared this list with countless visitors, I've distilled it down to my essential go-to spots, the one I eagerly introduce to first-time guests. So join me to unveil the finest attractions, culinary delights, and greatest bars in Berlin's most charming neighborhood. Moreover, if you're already familiar with the area, you're still gonna learn a lot of intriguing details, special weekday events, and insider tips that even sometimes some locals seem to not be aware about. And for those eager to dive even deeper into the hidden aspects of the Bergmannkiez, make sure to check out part 2 of this video about the hidden gems. We're talking clandestine Nazi film bunkers, off the beaten path hole-in-the-wall bistros, dive rock and roll music joints, vinyl stores, and even a hidden treasure buried inside the Kreuzberg Hill. So before we embark on our exploration, it's crucial to point out that the Bergmannkiez is the home to many locals. And while this fact also contributes to the charm of the neighborhood, it also underscores the importance of responsible traveling. So please, as a conscientious traveler, be aware that your presence has an impact on the places that you visit. Direct your attention and spending towards supporting local businesses, favoring them over larger chains. Be mindful of the cultural and natural environment of the area. Show appreciation to the individuals who contribute to the neighborhood's vibrancy, whether they're serving the food, playing the music, or enriching the community in other ways. And finally, take back souvenirs in the form of memories, stories that not only enrich your own experience, but also contribute to promoting and sustaining the unique character of the places that you visit. There we go. To begin, here's a little context and orientation. The Bergmannkiez is famous for having upkept its old Berliner flair. Recalling the city's golden age known as the Gründerzeit, when the city was in rapid expansion and full economic development. It's situated in the southwestern part of the greater district of Kreuzberg. The easiest way to get here is to exit at the Meringdamm U-Bahn station. The area begins here, stretching all the way east to Südstern and south to the infamous Tempelhof airfield, which, as we'll touch on in part 2, is why we have so many historical buildings that still stand today. By the way, the word Kiez, as in Bergmannkiez, is Berlin slang meaning hood or neighborhood. Because the city of Berlin is so vast that it's divided into districts that they themselves are unofficially subdivided into these smaller hoods or Kiez. To start your exploration, I recommend you head straight to the viewpoint and waterfall atop the Victoria Park, which is Berlin's oldest public park. What makes it unique in Berlin is the fact that it's a hill, it's topography. Berlin is otherwise very flat. In fact, only 66 meters high, everything is relative in life, but that is the highest peak in Berlin. At the summit, you'll find this massive monumental structure honoring Prussian victory against Napoleonic forces in the 19th century. And from up there, you're gonna get a breathtaking panoramic view of the entire city. Incidentally, the word Berg means mountain. Now, this mountain is actually more of a hill, but for Berlin standards, 66 meters is a mountain. So just go with it. When they planted this cross or Kreuz atop of the mountain, the Berg, it became known as the Kreuzberg, the namesake of the city. The development of the hill and its surroundings began in the 19th century. As the living conditions within the city walls deteriorated swiftly due to a quickly growing population, this area offered a contrast with its abundance of resources: fresh water, a brewery, open spaces, vineyards, and an intriguing establishment known as the Milchkuranstalt, a kind of dairy spa where people sought relief from ailments by unwinding and consuming warm, fresh milk.
Ein Schluck Milch, das wird Wunder.
But that's why today, en lieu of graffiti-strewn walls, you have 19th century facades juxtaposed against cascading waterfalls and panoramic vistas. So the area's foundation and evolution were rooted in good food and drink. In fact, remnants of the vineyard and the old Schultheis brewery still linger in the park today. Behind the hill, you can even find a hidden beer garden that adds to the charm. And there's a really cool local tradition to go to the pizzeria across the street, grabbing a pizza, bringing it up to the rolling hills, and enjoying the sunset over Berlin. Next, take a stroll along the Bergmannstraße, which, in my admittedly totally biased opinion, is the most beautiful street in all of Berlin. Formerly known as the Weinbergsweg or Wine Hill Path, it once traced the vineyards that adorned the Tempelhof Hills. A guy called Johann Caspar Bergmann, the owner, had a brilliant idea. He purchased the land, carved wine cellars into the hill, and established an inn. This sparked the rise of numerous beer gardens and breweries, turning it into a bustling hub of garden concerts, sports competitions, and variety shows. Today, the entire street and neighborhood bears his name, and while the beer garden is no more, the street is lined with a myriad of restaurants, bars, cafes, and shops, all independently owned. It's great that centuries later, the Bergmannkiez retained that same spirit, attracting creative entrepreneurs and locals seeking good food and drink. Also, if you happen to be around here end of June, make sure to check out the Kreuzberg Festival, where the whole street becomes a pedestrian zone with concerts, street food vendors, and games for everyone to enjoy. But with so many restaurants and vendors to choose from, it's hard to know where to go. So let me guide you through the most iconic food establishments in the Bergmannkiez that are an absolute must try. And let's start with the most well-known choices.
Mustafa's Gemüsekebab.
When you exit the U-Bahn station, your attention will likely be drawn to the long queue right next to the medieval castle-like looking building, which is, interestingly, our tax and revenue agency. But anyway, this line leads to Mustafa's Döner Kebab, an icon in Berlin's food scene. And while it's no secret that döner is a Turkish Berliner invention, did you know that there's actually two types of döner? The first one is the classic lamb döner, which we all know and love. But the second, my favorite one, is the Gemüse döner, where instead of lamb, you get delicious pieces of crispy and juicy chicken nestled inside a warm bun with fresh salad and fried vegetables. And don't be deterred by the lengthy queue or the presence of self-proclaimed lyrical geniuses. This place is absolutely worth it. Little local tip, if you don't want to do the queue, right around the corner, there's a place called York Döner, which also serves very good Gemüse Döner.
Keine Soße, nicht viele Sachen, kleines bisschen Zwiebel und kleines bisschen Kopfsalat, wie früher.
Currywurst, Berlin's most quintessential dish, boasts two iconic establishments, and one of them is in the Bergmannkiez. Curry 36, situated really close to Mustafa's Döner Kebab. Here, you can savor it in the authentic fashion, which means curbside, on a tall table, standing shoulder to shoulder with other eager patrons, using a picking fork to extract crispy bites of wurst from a rich, ketchupy sauce. And a vital tip for you, my esteemed visitors, if you are sitting down at a table ordering currywurst off of a menu with metal cutlery and a waiter, it means you've most likely stumbled into a tourist trap. Let's not forget that this dish was born out of the poverty in post-World War II Berlin, and Curry 36 in sorts genuinely embodies this old-school currywurst experience. And while this strip along Meringdam between Curry 36 and Mustafa's is a good place to hang out with other people, drinking beers, eating currywurst and döner, let's head into the heart of the neighborhood and discover its real food scene. At the opposite end of the Bergmannstraße, you'll find the Maheinecke Markthalle, the covered food market, a fixture for locals getting their daily essentials since 1892. And while most buildings in the area weathered the destruction of World War II, the Maheinecke Markthalle was completely reconstructed. Today it stands as a fantastic spot to head to find some authentic German sausage and cheese, but also an array of fine food representing nearly every country in Western Europe. And what's even better is that there's stands where you can bring food from different stalls and eat them together with friends. So you could be enjoying some fresh calamares from Lola's Tapas Bar, while your friends bring back some pastries from Les Epicuriens for dessert, making it this great multicultural feast. During the summer, I recommend to take the food outside where they set up tables, you can sit and soak in the local atmosphere. And local tip, there's a flea market that takes place on weekends outside of the market hall. All right, let's address the serious matter at hand. Where can you find a good schnitzel? While it's commonly acknowledged that the Wienerschnitzel has its roots in Vienna, maybe Milan, but not Germany, I've also heard someone say once that the best German food in Berlin is actually Austrian, which does hold a certain truth to it. In any case, if you're in the mood for a really good, authentic, Viennese-style Wienerschnitzel, then head to Felix Austria. The Wienerschnitzel here ticks all the boxes. Thin as paper, wide enough to cover the entire plate, twice, adorned with a delicate, crispy, golden crust, and filled with tender, juicy veal. The restaurant is charming, it's beautiful, it's a genuine spot to enjoy some delicious Austrian homemade comfort food. And be sure to reserve in advance. While German cuisine may face stiff competition from its French and Italian counterparts, it certainly holds its own unique and delicious appeal, especially when it's served with a modern, colorful twist like they do at Peter Schlemihl. The restaurant is cozy, situated on a charming cobblestone street near Kamisoplatz, which we'll talk more on in the next video, but offers a delightful culinary experience. Don't miss the Spätzle Allgäu, the traditional German egg noodles served with melted alpine cheese. For vibrant and imaginative brunch options, venture along the Bergmannstraße beyond the historical cemetery. Here, you'll discover a local favorite spot known as Two Trick Pony. Their kitchen offers seasonally inspired, well-executed dishes, all enjoyed on a lovely terrace next to the stunning Gothic church at Südstern. Now, speaking of religion, when the clock strikes 4 p.m. in Germany, it's the time for a ritual that holds almost sacred significance. Kaffee und Kuchen, or coffee and cake. And when I say cake, I mean cake. Not cake, but cake. I mean, just take a moment to enjoy this beautiful rendition of my personal favorite, the Black Forest cake. For an authentic experience in classic old-school Berliner pubs, also known as Eckkneipen or corner pubs, a visit to Distille is a must. The interior retains its original turn-of-the-century charm, featuring intricately carved woodwork. The clientele is a diverse mix of both young and old patrons, all gathered to engage in conversation and savor some of the house-distilled schnapps served directly from the flask. I highly recommend trying the hazelnut schnapps. Additionally, the three-star menu offers a combination of pretzel, a big sausage, and an even bigger pickle from the renowned Spreewald forest. Prost! For a more polished experience, head to Limonadier. Here, you'll find skillful mixologists crafting exceptional versions of well-known cocktails alongside in-house classics. This is bartending at its finest, and attention to detail takes center stage. Finally, my personal favorite spot, Jörgschlösschen. If you're in the mood for live music, Jörgschlösschen is where it's at. This avenue has not only endured the test of time, but also has been a local music hotspot for over a century. Here you can experience live performances and immerse yourself in an incredibly vibrant atmosphere. The musical genres span from jazz to blues and everything in between. Accompanied by straightforward German pub food, it's a guarantee of good times every time. And that wraps up part one of the Bergmannkiez, exploring the classics. In the next video, we're gonna explore the hidden gems, venturing into the side streets and uncovering underground secrets of the area. Nazi film bunkers, concealed treasures within the mountain, rock and roll dive bars, hidden hole-in-the-wall bistros, and more. That's going to be released in 2 weeks, so make sure to subscribe. That being said, enjoy your time in the neighborhood, and I'll see you soon.